This is my first idea camp, and I actually didn't know what to expect before I came here. It's like, how are they going to make it to bring like more than 50 people from different countries, from different areas, with different backgrounds, and then all of us here feeding ideas, facilitating. And I'm actually impressed how all this worked, because I really didn't have any idea before. I had not been followed. And I'm actually curious to know, David, have you been to previous idea camps? Is this very different from the previous ones?
Yes, I was in the first one, and well, it was, I had the, more or less the same feeling you have now. It was very interesting to see how many people, and the thing is that the format was quite different in the fact that instead of this system we have now based on these games or steps, no? What we had was a trolley that was the device to set up our idea. So, because then I was an idea maker. And it was like everything was more like idea center, no? And I mean, each idea maker, we had our trolley, so it was what we called ideas on wheels, because it had wheels, it was movable. So we went around to different spaces, like trying to explain and work with the others the ideas, and then document it through with the trolley.
Okay.
And well, it went very well, but this time I feel that everything is more like based in the situation of collaboration, of co-creation, and it's more like the dynamics are like okay, let's talk about this specific subject or this specific aspect of how to develop your ideas, and you do it together.
Okay.
So I think it's quite an improvement somehow.
I really like this methodology. I did not get the point before actually coming here. I was a little concerned, like, how is this methodology going to work? I had never seen a circular methodology where one step and then another step, another step. And I was in the storytelling step, how to tell your story, and I did not have a clear idea of how the steps connected. And now it makes total sense. What step were you in?
I was in a fifth step. It's okay. A vision and the impact.
How did that work?
And to me, it was very interesting in a way to see how people are trying to focus and narrow down the idea, because they're coming with the idea. Okay, some of them are very developed and already in the process of implementation, but some of them are only ideas that have to become concrete things that they are going to work on. And somehow I think that it's a very emotional situation also, especially in the situations where the idea is not in the process of implementation, that you have to like divorce yourself from this idealistic image you have in your head and then put it down, like this is the first step you have to take, and then the second and the third, to make it a vision become true in a way. And this process of making things more concrete and applicable is very, I think it's very interesting and intensive. And to me it also seemed a bit strange to find this step on the fifth, as a fifth one. And because when I would like structure the project, I would always start from the vision and the concrete steps I have to take, and then fill with others. But the structure, circular structure, is somehow that is puzzle in which every step is equally important and equally relevant, and that they're just at some point they get together, so it's not important at which point you're working on. And in that sense it seemed to me that it was really well done methodological structure.
What did your step look like?
Well, mine was step two, and it was about networking. So what we did is like, okay, we would ask the case giver which were the stakeholders he or she had in mind, and usually we saw a situation where there was some kind of imbalance. I mean, in the, some of them were very, very clear on what communities they were targeting, what peer connections they had, or networks or others put the, I mean, it was more intense in the part of funding, institutional, things like that. So our role was a little bit, okay, let's try to balance this. And we did it along with the rest of the idea makers. So everyone would play the role of a possible stakeholder, a potential stakeholder. And then we would exchange questions and answers. And it was like a, very much like a game, no? And especially when we had, you know, some movement, there was real interesting moments. I think we were kind of, all of us were learning about how to set up a network which is healthy, which is balanced. And it was also like fun. I mean, it's really dynamic. No?
It's very interesting that you two seem to really, because of the nature of your step, to try to bring them back to earth, to like very tangible things and processes. And my step was quite different because it's step six is go beyond that. So you have to envision how will your project be in like 1 or 2 years time. Imagine that it's up and running because you need that image in order to also get energy to go backwards and see what you need to get there. And once you have this image of how there's, for instance, this project of people on a rooftop. So it's a very powerful image to imagine people partying and doing things together on a rooftop. It's a completely different perspective of a city. You have the city, you have the underground, and now you have the above ground, which is the rooftops. So we wanted really to also don't lose the poetic side of it, that we're really, really doing this because we're passionate, they're passionate about something. So that image also keeps them stronger. And then that also helps identify your audiences, your messages, how are you going to share your storytelling, who do you want to talk to. So I think it was a perfect combination of like idealistic and very like down-to-earth methodology.
But what I like actually about this this structure is the part beneath is that we are working here on a methodology and the community is in the center of the idea camp. But I really liked to see how they were all engaged in the case we were working on and that somehow they weren't competitive, you know, and that from the very beginning, the community is created in through the groups that are moving together and going through the whole process together, and that they're somehow all interested in feeding into each other's ideas and making them more more grounded, more opulent. And more.
Did you see lots of room for collaboration, for potential doing things together?
I don't know. I think it's very complicated because I think that they can help each other with their different experiences and different insights, different approaches. But to see the, I think since they are working with the, since they are working with the specific kinds of communities in different countries, that it would be very hard to really establish international collaboration in that sense. But I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. What's your impression?
For us, it was clearly like a situation which was a collective intelligence. They were willing to collaborate. Sometimes it was even, okay, now I have to identify my potential partner. So I think that guy over there in another group is a potential partner for my project. So we had another idea feeder that would play the role of this other idea feeder. So it was kind of transpersonal thing. And I'm really happy about that part. And on the other side, I mean, I'm amazed about how the physical part of the methodology connects to the digital part. Yes. I mean, because we have like this clearly complementary two layers that for me, I think is they're working very good, no?